Hey everybody, and thanks for stopping by my channel. This video is going to be all about my gun journey, how I got started with guns and how I've progressed with them and where I'm at now. I'm hoping a video like this might be interesting or helpful to some people who might be on the fence about owning a gun or carrying a gun. So yeah, I'm just gonna go ahead and jump right into the very beginning of my story. So my story starts about 14 years ago in Maryland. That's where my husband and I were living at the time. I was either pregnant or I just had my first kid, and my husband came home with a shotgun. I think it was a 12 gauge shotgun. I had never used a gun, shot a gun. I probably had never seen a gun in real life, held a gun. I grew up in Maryland where guns are almost banned. It's really difficult to have guns and use guns in Maryland. I also had a person in my family that was killed with a gun, so I kind of had maybe a little fear of them. It wasn't crazy or anything. I wasn't terrified of guns, but I just wasn't comfortable around them because it just wasn't part of my life. So anyway, my husband came home with his shotgun for me because he traveled a lot for work at the time, and I was at home with a little baby, and he wanted me to have a way to, you know, protect myself and our kid if anything happened at the house. I don't remember learning how to shoot it at the time. I remember him kind of walking me through how the gun worked and basically hoping that if someone did break in the house, all I would have to do is rack the slide. They would hear that noise and they would run away because the sound of a shotgun being racked is really scary. So that was kind of the plan in the very beginning. My husband wasn't raised with guns either. He didn't have them in the house. He was from Maryland also, but he was in the Marines for many years and he was trained with guns and used to them in the military. So he definitely wanted us to have at least a gun in the house and to be able to use it. But back then, I really did not show any interest in this shotgun at all. I really wanted nothing to do with it. It stayed locked up in the closet. I don't think I shot that gun for several years. I just wasn't that interested in it, and he didn't really push it on me at the time either. So anyway, fast forward a few years, we moved to Virginia, the land of everyone has a gun. You can carry open, you can carry concealed. It's amazing. So yeah, he was quite excited to be living here. He thought it was time to really get my butt in gear with learning how to use a gun. So he came home one day with a revolver. This revolver, this giant revolver, this heavy, scary looking revolver. This thing is not loaded, as you can see. But anyway, he came home with this. This is a Taurus 38 Special. I don't know the exact brand of what it is, but it's a 38 Special. So anyway, this thing is a monster. And I kind of fell in love with it. I was a little bit scared of it, but he took me to a gun range here in Virginia. And I can remember holding this gun and pointing it at the target. And I pulled the trigger. And the gun went bang and I hit the target and I was like, I want to do it again. I can't wait to do this again. This is amazing. I love this. I thought this was like the most exciting thing I had ever done in my life. I found out I'm actually a pretty good shot. I was able to hit the target the entire time. I thought this gun was very simple and easy to use. You know, you press a little button, you pop this open, you put your rounds in there, close it up, and you were good to go. I just thought it was really easy. Also, because this gun is so big and so heavy, it takes a lot of the recoil. So I didn't have a lot of issues with like my hand hurting. Maybe my hand got a little bit tired just because it's heavy and holding it up, but not from recoil. So that was great. I still love shooting this gun. I've probably been shooting this for 10 years now and I never get tired of this. This is the gun that stayed like in the nightstand for many years next to the bed. This was the home protection gun. Still wasn't interested in the shotgun. This is the one I would go to if I needed it. But this obviously was not a gun that I could carry around outside, because how am I going to hide this, really? So I discovered I had this love for revolvers. I love the simplicity of them. I love how they don't have many moving parts. I love how they don't break very easily. I think it's just easy to load. I think it's easy to shoot. It's easy to clean. I just wanted something that was very simple. So my husband got his concealed carry and he was carrying a Springfield XDS semi-automatic and he wanted me to carry. I probably fought him for a good year or so, not wanting to do it. I thought it's going to be uncomfortable. I'm gonna have a hard time finding clothes that fit properly. I'm gonna be scared to carry a gun around outside. What if I shoot myself? There was a lot of fears going on in my head. A lot of like, I'm not very interested in actually walking around outside carrying a gun. I loved having the gun in the house, but carrying it outside was a whole different story for me. So it took me a long time to get used to the idea. And I really wanted to stress this part in my video to people because I have had several men in my videos say things to me like, you know, wow, this is great, a girl that's comfortable with a gun. I wish my wife or my girlfriend would be the same way. And my response to that is give them time. They might come around, but it might take some time. It might take a few months. It might take a few years for them to feel comfortable with doing it. So anyway, my husband wore me down and convinced me to get my concealed carry. Here in Virginia, it was quite simple. I had to get some instruction training done. I actually went to this man's house where he does instruction. It was me and a friend of mine, and we listened to him talk for several hours. But I had to take a test when he was done, and then we went to the gun range and he watched us shoot to make sure we were using our guns properly and being safe about it. And then we got a certificate. Had to go to the courthouse, fill out some paperwork, pay a fee. I don't remember what the fee was because this was a while ago. And then in about a week or two, I got my concealed carry permit in the mail. And then I was ready to actually go out into the world with a gun. So remember, I like revolvers, right? I didn't want to carry a semi-automatic because I thought I'm not smart enough, really. I really thought that it was kind of above my head with all the parts to it. And so I just wanted to keep it simple and easy. So we picked out a Ruger LCR for me. Again, it's not loaded. This is a great gun. This is small, it's concealable, it's not too heavy, it's easy to shoot. It's not too heavy to carry, but it is heavy enough that it does take a lot of the recoil when you're practicing. There isn't a hammer, there isn't a safety on this. You pull it out, you shoot it, and that's it. I really like this gun. I was very happy with this gun for a long time, and this is the gun that I carried for several years. And in those few years of me carrying the Ruger revolver, I also was shooting lots of other guns at the same time. We have friends that have a farm, and we go down to their house and shoot in their backyard. A lot of our friends have lots of different guns themselves, and so we all just kind of show up and lay all the guns out. It's a full-blown arsenal. It's really cool, and we just kind of pick and choose what we feel like shooting that day. And so I was able to try out lots of different types of guns, big ones, little ones, everything. I have a lot of girlfriends who also carry, so I was, you know, involved in a community where everybody is carrying and talking about guns and shooting guns, and it just made it a whole lot more normal for me. It was just a normal part of life. It got to the point to where if I wasn't carrying when I left the house, I felt weird about it. It's not how it started out though. I would put the gun on, leave the house, and be miserable the whole time. But after about a year or so, if I forgot to take my gun with me or I couldn't make it conceal in what I was wearing and I left it at home, I would be scared the whole time I was out. I would be thinking, oh great, today is the day something is going to happen and I'm not going to be able to protect myself or my kids, and this sucks. So I wanted to make sure that no matter what, every time I left the house and it was legal for me to carry, because sometimes I do go to Maryland to visit family and I can't carry there and that sucks. But whenever it is legal for me to carry, I wanted to make sure I always leave the house with a gun. And sometimes the revolver was a little bit hard for me to conceal, or sometimes it would just get a little bit uncomfortable because of the shape of it. As you can imagine, this piece here can get a little bit uncomfortable. It sticks out a little bit and it presses in different parts of my back that just didn't feel great. I like to go outside, go hiking and climbing up cliffs and all this crazy stuff. And sometimes this gun just didn't work for me. So I wanted something that was much smaller and slimmer and much more comfortable and would hide in everything. I watched a lot of review videos, especially Thalia Photography. I don't know where she's at now. She doesn't make videos anymore, but she was fantastic. Anyway, she reviewed the Ruger LCP. and she really liked it. So I thought, well, if she likes it, I'm sure I'll like it, because I thought she was just, you know, amazing. So I went and got one without shooting it, and that was a mistake. Here is the Ruger LCP. Again, no magazine, it's not loaded. And here we go, the Ruger LCR. This one is much bigger and much heavier. This gun is the easiest thing to conceal. You could probably conceal this in a bathing suit. It's that easy. But it is a real bitch to shoot. I hated shooting this thing. I never enjoyed shooting this thing, not once. I've had many issues with it malfunctioning. I've had issues with it jamming. Some of those issues were my own problem because I wasn't gripping it properly at the time. But since I fixed my grip and I've had other people shoot this gun that had a perfect grip with it, it still has had issues. But this time I did a whole lot more research than I had done with this one. I shopped around for a long time for my next gun. I tried out lots of different guns, and the one I picked was the Glock 43. So here is the Glock 43. Again, this thing is not loaded. And I love this thing. I love this thing so much. It is a little bit harder to conceal. It doesn't conceal perfectly and everything, so I do have to work a little bit harder to hide this thing. But this is the gun that has kind of changed my opinion about semi-automatics. I used to only want to shoot revolvers because I thought I'm never going to be smart enough to figure out a semi-automatic. But this gun made me love them. I think this gun is so simple and so easy to use. I love how slim this gun is. It's really flat on the sides, so it makes it really comfortable to carry. This gun shoots perfectly every time. I love the Glock so much that I've decided that I'm going to get the Glock 42 as well, and probably use that as a summer carry and use this as a winter carry. So I guess that's pretty much my whole story. I'm constantly trying out new guns because, like I said, my friends all have different kinds of guns and we still go down to the farm and shoot. My whole family has a membership at the range by our house. We go quite often. My kids are involved in a 4-H shooting club. My husband is a 4-H shooting instructor for shotguns and rifles. So it really is kind of a whole family fun thing that we do together now. And it's kind of funny because I started out being really kind of like, eh, icky guns. And now here I am trying to spread the word about how guns are awesome and how you should really think about owning them and carrying them so you can protect yourself and the people around you. You never know what kind of situation you might end up in one day, God forbid, but you don't want to be that person that is huddled in the corner somewhere when there's someone else, a bad guy with a gun, shooting innocent people. You want to be able to do something about it. You want to have at least a chance. All right, guys, I'm going to go ahead and end this video here. I hope some of you have found this video a little helpful. If you have any questions for me, let me know down below, and let me know where you guys got started with your gun journey. What gun did you start with? What gun are you using now? I'm really interested in stuff like that. I hope y'all have a great week, and I'll see y'all soon. Bye.